Hello and welcome to this video regarding advanced access management. With Lansweeper Cloud, you're able to link multiple on-premise installations to one single cloud site. And with that comes the question of access management. As a big company that has multiple geographical locations or multiple departments that aren't necessarily allowed to look at all of the data, it's important that you can specifically target who can see which data. So with that, we're going to take a look in Lansweeper Cloud on what the options are regarding access management, how granular you can provide access to data, and all of the other options included. So let's take a look. So here in Lansweeper Cloud, in order to view our access management, we have to start and navigate to our configuration, which is where under the account management, we'll actually find roles and permissions. This is quite similar to how our on-prem solution also manages access. So you have a couple of default roles that indicate what a person can and cannot do. One big change, however, that we've done is made sure that the roles specifically include all of the roles that you should really have. So we have, for each specific piece in Lansweeper Cloud, create, view, edit, and delete permissions. So you can very granularly select, okay, this person can create or only view, or only edit or only delete, whichever combination that you want. We've made sure that it's there and that you can select whatever you need. So at the top left, we have an overview of all of the permissions that we can adjust, ranging from inventory to all the way to configuration. And then at the bottom, we have scopes. So currently we're looking at the view data role, and we can already filter if we want this role to only be able to view data on either my test installation or my home lab installation. So we already have a kind of primary way of doing our advanced access management just simply based on the installation. Now, if you want to go further, this is where scopes come in. And scopes really allow you to select and apply this role on a specific subset of assets. So going even deeper than the level of installation. So let's create a scope and see what we can do here. So with a new asset scope, we have to actually give it a name. So we're going to take use the example of Linux devices. Let's say that we have a specific person that is only allowed or only manages all the Linux devices within our organization. And because he only manages Linux devices, we only want him to see and perform actions on the Linux devices. So we'll call this one Linux. We're not going to add a description. And then for the conditions, we have some options, but we're going to go with asset type equals 2, and then find here basically Linux. There we go. So if we save this one, we have a scope that is specifically made for Linux assets. And then heading back to our view data role and scopes, we can now select our new scope that we have created. So this way, this role, anyone with this role, be able to view data, but only view data from Linux devices. And again, if we want to limit it further, we can say, okay, we only want this person to be able to view Linux devices from my home lab. So let's save this role, exit out, and apply this to one of our accounts. So we have one person here that already has the view data role, but let's just invite someone new to our site, one of the random people that we have here, and make sure that this person has the view data role there and add them to it. So right now you can see that we have the view data role here applied to two of our users. To make this a bit more clear on exactly what they're allowed to see, we're going to head over back to our roles and permissions, where you can see that here in the overview, it shows you exactly what installations and what scopes are applied. But we can actually also simply edit the name and make it view data home Linux, just to make this clear. Save the role, exit out. And now if we go back to our accounts, we actually have a better sense of what these people can manage and what they can actually do with their specific role. So with the advanced access management, it's great to really specify who can access what kind of data. And remember, these roles and permissions go throughout the entire interface. So it also applies to reports and any other piece of information that is within Lansweeper. So you can really control who has access to what kind of data. Great for use cases where larger organizations have multiple geolocations, multiple installations, multiple departments that aren't allowed to see all of the data at once. And that's it for Advanced Access Management. Thank you for watching.